Focus on Digital Electronics. We are discussing the design of combinational circuits, in which first we identified the number of inputs and outputs, and after that we develop behavioral truth table, taking inputs in columns and outputs, and writing SOP expressions and simplifying those expressions. After simplifying, we implement those SOP expressions with the help of gates. So this is the basic procedure we are following. Now let us today discuss need for tri-state buffers and the operation of a tri-state buffer and the design of comparator circuits. The tri-state buffers are very important elements which are helpful in the design and interfacing of different devices. And the operation of the tri-state buffer we will see with the help of truth table, and how it operates in three states we will see, and 2-bit comparator also we will discuss. Now let us see digital buffer. So the buffer takes the input and produces at its output. If A equals to 1, Q equals to also 1. If A equals to 0, Q equals also 0. So this is the buffer action, digital buffer. So in the digital buffer, we have Q equals to A. So this is the Boolean expression for the digital buffer. So in digital electronics, three-state, tri-state or three-state logic allows an output port to assume a high impedance state, effectively removing the output from the circuit, in addition to the 0 and 1 logic levels. This allows multiple circuits to share the same output line, or lines such as a bus, which cannot listen to more than one device at a time. Three-state outputs are implemented in many resistors, bus drivers and flip-flops in the 7400 and 4000 series, as well as in other types, but also internally in many integrated circuits. So other typical uses are internal and external buses in microprocessors, computer memory and peripherals. So many devices are controlled by an active low input called output enable, active low output enable, OE bar, which dictates whether the outputs should be held in a high impedance state or drive their respective loads to the bus. So this is the importance and the necessity of tri-state buffers. So the tri-state buffer is a three-state logic. So we are studying so far with the two-state logic, that is logic 0 and logic 1. But here another additional state is available, that is the high impedance state. When the circuit is not in logic 1 or logic 0, then the circuit will be held in high impedance state. So that gives the possibility of the tri-state buffer to be isolated from the other circuits when it is not needed. Whenever it is needed in the circuits to send the information or to receive the information, so then that circuit can be activated and connected to respective devices or buses with the help of tri-state buffers. So this facilitates the important activity of sharing the information through common bus lines. So that is a important necessity of three-state or tri-state buffer. So three-state buffers can be used to implement efficient multiplexers, especially those with large number of inputs. And three-state buffers are essential to the operation of a shared electronic bus. That means the electronic lines or communicating lines can be shared between many number of devices. So that is the advantage of tri-state buffer, which will be used as a interfacing device so that it can be helpful to use the common bus between many number of devices. So by using more than one device with a common wires it will eliminate the possibility of more number of communicating wires. So that is the added advantage. For example, if the tri-state buffers are not used, then we have to use more number of communicating wires to connect devices. So this will increase the complexity of the circuit and unnecessary hardware and so much confusion communicating lines. So this is the importance of tri-state buffer. So this is called you can call it as a tri-state multiplexing or Charlie plexing. So what is actually the tri-state buffer? It is a switch which has three states: high state, low state, high impedance state, that is the floating. When two or more devices are connected to a common bus, tri-state buffers are used, which will prevent the access of the bus at the same time by more than one device. So this is the symbol of a tri-state buffer with active high enable. So its inputs. So it has three terminals: input terminal, output terminal, and enable terminal. So here we can call it as enable or disable control signal. So this control signal is active low control signal. So here whenever the enable is zero, then only the buffer is activated, because there is a bubble. If you observe here is the bubble. So this bubble indicates that this is the active low enable signal. So whenever zero is applied to this enable signal, that is during this combination, the device is activated. So whenever the device is activated, if the data input is zero, then the output is also zero. If the data input is one, the output is one. That means output equals to input whenever the device is enabled. If the device is disabled by applying one, then whatever the data that is at the input side, it will not be transferred to output, and the data output is just floating. It is floating. That means this side devices, whatever may be connected to this data input, for example, then that device is disconnected from the output. So this is called floating. So let us see the other types of tri-state buffers. There are total 4 tri-state buffers we can observe here. That is active high, not inverted. You observe here one important thing. You observe here, that is the enable signals. If you observe here, these two devices, first two devices, are having active high enable signals. Active high enabled signals. Whenever one is applied, then only these devices are activated. So these two are active high device tri-state buffers, and which will be enabled with one logic one. And similarly, if you observe these devices, observe here, there is a bubble enable signal with a bubble. So that means these are the active low tri-state buffers. These are active low tri-state buffers. So now that means whenever the enable signal is zero, then only the device's tri-state buffers are activated. And next classification like this. Observe here, these two devices, observe here, outputs. If you observe outputs, there is no bubble for this device and this device. Both these two devices do not have bubbles. So because there are no bubbles, these are called non-inverting tri-state buffers. Non-inverting tri-state buffers. Next, if you observe, next to two, these two tri-state buffers, and what you observe is, you see the output is bubble. There is a bubble at the output. That means it is called inverting tri-state buffer. You see, this is the inverting tri-state buffer. So this is the way of naming of tri-state. So there are total 4 types of tri-state buffers available. And let us observe here the tri-state buffer and its truth tables. Now, so this is the first tri-state buffer. This is the first tri-state buffer. It is the active high non-inverting tri-state buffer. Active high non-inverting tri-state buffer. So whenever the enable signal B is 0, then the device is in high impedance state. Whenever enable signal B is 1, then the output C is equals to the A. Output C is equals to the A. So this is the active high non-inverting tri-state buffer. And next. So this is the active low non-inverting tri-state buffer. at too low, non-inverting. So whenever the signal B, control signal, enable signal B is 0, then only the device is activated. Otherwise, it is in high impedance state. So whenever the B equals to 0 means C equals to A. B equals to 1 means the device is in high impedance state. Next, let us observe here. This device is active high inverting tri-state buffer. Active high inverting tri-state buffer. So this is whenever B equals to 1, then only the device is activated, and it is inverting 1, hence C equals to A bar. Observe here, whenever enable signal B equals to 1, C equals to, this C equals to A bar. If the B equals to 0, 0 means it will be in high impedance state. So this is a active high inverting tri-state buffer. Next, if you observe another active low, this is the active low inverting tri-state buffer. So whenever B equals to 0, then the device is activated, C equals to A bar. Whenever B equals to 1, that means it is deactivated, then it will be floating, that is, it is in high impedance state. So these are the tri-state buffers and their respective truth tables. Now let us see the tri-state buffer, how it will be constructed using CMOS technology. Here, observe here, this is the construction. This is the active low inverting tri-state buffer. Active low inverting tri-state buffer. Now, what it is done is, so this enable signal is given to, these two are PMOS transistors. These two are NMOS transistors. So PMOS can be identified with bubble at the gate. At the gate, bubbles are there. That is the PMOS. So these two are, upper two are PMOS, lower two transistors are the NMOS transistors. And what you have to do is, you have to give the enable signal to the PMOS and the NMOS with one of them is inverted, like this. So to the PMOS, observe here, to the PMOS you have to give enable complement of the enable signal to the PMOS, and to the NMOS you have to give uncomplemented enable signal. So like this you have to give, and with the help of NOT gate you can do like this. And observe here, the construction is clear that whenever enable signal is active low, then the Y equals to A. That means whatever the input A is applied, it will be transferred to the output. So this is the construction of tri-state buffer. For example, let us discuss with one example. For example, A equals to 0. the active low enable signal is activated. So that means Y equals to, whenever A equals to 0 means this is conducting, this PMOS is conducting, and the enable signal is activated, it is 0, this is also conducting, both PMOSs are conducting when A equals to 0, and NMOSs are, because A equals to 0 means this NMOS is switched off, not conducting, and this NMOS, because it is a active low control signal, this is also off, both NMOSs are off, and hence the output, both PMOSs are conducting, the output Y is connected to VDD, that is logic 1. So whenever A equals to 0, Y equals to 1, that is, it is inverting, it is the inverting buffer. So active low inverting tri-state buffer. Okay, now let us see, whenever when A equals to 1, when A equals to 1, what happens is both this top PMOS is switched off, and enable signal is also activated. It is enable signal equals to 1 here in this case. Enable signal equals to 1. Then what happens is, let us consider first enable equals to 0. Enable equals to 0. Then what happens is, whenever enable equals to 0, this is conducting, but whenever enable equals to 1, enable equals to 1, this is conducting. So when enable equals to 1 and A equals to 1, then this is activated, both NMOSs are activated, hence Y is connected to ground, Y is connected to ground. That means whenever A equals to 1, output Y equals to 0. So this is the non-inverting tri-state, inverting tri-state buffer. Now let us observe here the necessity and application of the tri-state buffers, and here if you observe how the decoders and tri-state buffers plays important role, let us observe this circuit. For example, this is a single wire, a single wire. To this wire, because device A is connected, device A is connected, device B, C, D. There are four devices are connected to single wire through tri-state buffers like this. So the tri-state buffer used are active high non-inverting tri-state buffers, active high non-inverting tri-state buffer, because active high means there is no bubble here, non-inverting means there is no bubble at the output. So this you have to remember, and you see these four devices are connected with the help of four tri-state buffers. So device 1, device B, device 1, 2, 3, device 4. These are connected to the tri-state buffers with the through these tri-state buffers, these devices are connected to the common wire. And observe here how the decoder plays important role also. You can observe here. A decoder is used. This is the 2 to 4 decoder. This is the 2 to 4 decoder. So with the help of this decoder, the 4 tri-state buffers can be activated or deactivated. For example, let us consider zero zero decoder 2 to 4. So buffer selector, tri-state buffer selection inputs, these are called tri-state buffer selection inputs. 0 0 0 1, this is the S0 S1. These S0 S1 will select one of the tri-state buffers. So because there are 2 selection lines, 4 combinations, 0 0 0 1 1 0 and 1 1 1 1. So whenever 0 0 is there, whenever 0 0 combination, so output Q0 is activated. This output Q0 is activated, and whenever this is activated, this is connected to this buffer. So device 4 is activated. Device 4 is activated. So this device 4 is connected to the common wire. This is the common wire. So the device 4 is connected to this wire. All other devices, because this is 0, this is 0, this is 0, this is 1. Q0 output is 1, Q1, Q2, Q3 outputs are 0, 0, 0. Hence, these 3 tri-state buffers are deactivated. Only this 4th one is activated. Hence, the 4th device is connected to the common wire. This is the common wire. So the data can be placed by the 4th device onto the device, onto the wire bus. Otherwise it can read also the data from the bus. So this is the way of interfacing the devices to the common bus system. So this is very, very important. You observe here, decoder plays important role, and tri-state buffers also plays important role for the interfacing of different devices to the common bus system. For example, let us see 0 1 selection lines. 0 1 is there. Then at that case, this Q1 output is 1. And all other outputs are zeros. That means only this device is activated. Hence, the 3rd device is connected to the common wire bus system like this. So it can transfer the 3rd device through tri-state buffer. It can send data to the bus or receive the data from the bus. So like this, the communication will take place. All other these three tri-state buffers are disconnected or isolated from the common bus. This is very important. These three tri-state buffers in high impedance state, whenever the enable signal is not activated, means that respective tri-state buffer is in high impedance state and isolated from the common bus line, isolated from the common bus line. This is the way of connecting. Similarly, for 1 0, this device is activated and second device is connected to the common bus. For 1 1, first device is connected to the bus. Bus device is connected to the bus, and the data transfer will take place. Like this, this is a very, very important understanding you have to get. Let us observe another circuit. So this is a common bus system, data bus system. To this bus, now to this common bus system, there are different devices are connected like this. For example, you see the device 1, you see device 1, which is connected to this tri-state buffer, is sending data to bus. Similarly, the device, another device here, 1, 2, this is also sending data to the common bus, third device and fourth device. So four devices are connected to their respective tri-state buffers, and they can send the data to common bus through tri-state buffers. And observe here, another devices are connected here, device 5, and here the device 6. So these devices 6, 5 and 6 are reading the data from the data bus through tri-state buffer like this. Okay, so that means, for example, if the device want to transfer data from device 1, want to communicate and send the data to device 6 like this, then what happens is the decoder will activate this buffer and this buffer. Decoder is not shown in this diagram. To get the simplified diagram, we have drawn like this. Okay, and so these two tri-state buffers are activated. Hence, the device 1 data is placed on the data bus, and that data is received by the device 6 like this. So this is the way of communication. Like this, you see, like this. The data flows. Similarly, if the device 4 want to communicate device 5, then it will send the data like this. So this is the example of how the data transfer take place between the devices. So here, now let us consider another case of a detailed bus diagram and with a decoder, how three devices are connected. So here, device 1 is connected like this. So this is the device 1, and here the device 2. And here the device 4. So the device 1, 2, 3, total 3 devices are there, which are connected to a common bus system, which has 4 lines, 1, total 4 lines. If you observe, these are the 4 lines. So 1, 2, 3, 4 lines, 4 connecting lines are there. You observe here, the decoder, it can select, activate one of the devices. So device 1 can send the device 1. Device 1 can send 4-bit data to the bus. Here the 4-bit data. For example, device 1 is there. This is the device 1. It can send 4-bit data through 4 lines. So device 1 is having 4 outputs. That means it can send the data, 4-bit data, to the common bus through tri-state buffers. So how many tri-state buffers are needed for this device? 4 tri-state buffers are needed. So hence these are the 4 tri-state buffers taken and which are used to interface the device 1 to the common bus. Similarly, device 2, device 3 also the same case. And the tri-state buffers are active high non-inverting tri-state buffers. So the enable signals of the tri-state buffers are controlled by the decoder like this. So here, if the decoder activates this output line, first output line, then these buffers, all these buffers are connected, enable signals are tied together to the first decoder output. So this is the first decoder output. So the decoder output is activated, means then only all these 4 buffers are activated, and device 2, then it is connected to the common bus and it can send the 4-bit data to the common bus like this. And output of decoder, output 2 of decoder is connected to this buffer set. Hence device 1 is connected. Whenever output 2 is activated, device 1 is connected to the common bus system. It can send the 4-bit data to the bus. Similarly, in the case of third device also the same. So here, observe here the clarity diagram we have drawn like this. You see, device A is interfaced to the system bus. This is the system bus. The system bus is having 4 lines, 4 copper wire lines. So these 4 copper wire lines are 4-bit data bus. This is common to all devices. Observe here, device A is connected through the buffer set. 4 buffers are used and these 4 buffers enable signals are tied together and connected to the decoder, and the decoder activates these 4 buffers. Hence the device A is connected to the system bus like this. It can send the 4-bit data to the system bus like this. Similarly, in the case of device B also. So the device B is connected here first output of the decoder is connected to device A buffers. Second output of decoder is connected to device B buffers. Enable signals of device B buffers. Similarly, third output is connected to device C buffers. Fourth output is connected to device So this is the very clarity diagram we have shown here, how the devices are connected or interfaced to the common bus system through buffers, it is shown. So let us see the bus transceiver here. The bus transceiver is the one which is very simply constructed. So let us take two buffers here, just two buffers, buffer one and here buffer two, like this, because the enable signals here, active high enable signal for this, active low enable signal for this down buffer. Okay, that means both are connected to a common line like this. Then whenever enable equals to 1, then the upper tri-state buffer is activated, lower tri-state buffer is deactivated. Hence the data is transferred like this. The data transfers like this. So the same diagram shown here, you see the buffer 1 here, active high non-inverting buffer, and the active high, active low, this is the active low. This is also active high, both are active high, but you see the device with the help of inverter, not gate, we are enabling either this or this, buffer 1 or buffer 2. For example, if the enable equals to 1, whenever enable equals to 1, then here that 1 activates the buffer 1, and this output of NOT gate is 0, hence the buffer 2 is deactivated. Buffer 2 is deactivated, buffer 1 is activated. So now whenever it is buffer 1 is activated, the direction of the data transfer will be like this. This is the direction of the data transfer, because buffer 1 is activated with enable 1 and buffer 2 is deactivated. The data transfers like flows like this. So this is the output, this is the input. So now let us see, whenever enable equals to 0, whenever enable equals to 0, then buffer 1 is deactivated, buffer 2 is activated. Whenever buffer 2 is activated, the data transfer will take place like this. This is the path of the data transfer. So that means so because enable equals 0, this is deactivated, buffer 1 deactivated. Because enable 0 means output of NOT gate is 1, buffer 2 is activated. That is the meaning. So the data transfer takes place like this. So that means this is called bus transceiver. With the help of bus transceiver, we can use a common line as a IO line, IO communicating, input-output line. So bidirectional data transfer, full duplex data transfer is possible like this. The data may be transferred like this or like this. So this is possible with the transceiver, bus transceiver. That means it transmit and receive through common line. So we have different ICs available, 7400 series ICs for the tri-state buffers. Let us take 74125. This is the IC, 74125 IC. This is the quad tri-state buffers. In this IC, we have four non-inverting active low tri-state buffers. These are the non-inverting active low tri-state buffers available to us. So this is the 74125 IC and the 74126 IC is also there. This is also having four such tri-state buffers available in a single IC, and this is active high non-inverting tri-state buffers, four tri-state buffers available, 74126. And the next 74385, 74386, and 74367, 368. These are the different types of tri-state ICs available to us. And CMOS architecture also, 4503 hex non-inverting buffer with the tri-state outputs, 4503, and so that is one available to us. Next, so now let us conclude this lesson that we have discussed the construction and the design of tri-state buffers, and the necessity of the tri-state buffers we have discussed, how the tri-state buffers and decoders plays important role in interfacing the different other devices with the common bus system in a computer's system. In the next class, we discuss comparators. Thank you.